Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. In this episode, let me show you how you can create a keyboard shortcut or an icon in the dock so you can quickly switch between light and dark modes on your Mac. I couldn't do MacMost without its supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So dark mode is a great thing, and a lot of people like to use it, but some people like to switch between light and dark modes frequently throughout the day. Sometimes there's just some sort of tasks that are better suited towards one or the other, or other times we just like to break up the fatigue of staring at the screen by switching between light and dark modes. So what would be great is to have a switch where you can quickly switch with either one click or a keyboard shortcut between the two modes. You can set that up using Automator. Let's take a look. Alright, so whether you're in Catalina or in Mojave, if you go to System Preferences, you can click on General and then you get the option to switch between light and dark modes. In Catalina you also get an auto setting too. But what if you want to switch manually? If you just want to be able to switch quickly between light and dark and you don't want to launch System Preferences, go to General and then go and click one of these buttons. Well, you can get some apps that will do this for you, but you don't need to install anything new onto your Mac to do this because you can create something very simple, an Automator to do this, and assign it to a keyboard shortcut even. So just run Automator and then choose Quick Action. We're going to set this up as a Quick Action first. So Quick Action, we're just going to receive no input from anything because we don't need any input for this. We're going to have it work in any application. And you can change the icon and color if you want. I'll leave them as the defaults. Now we're going to look in here under Actions and make sure Library selected so you can search everything. And we're going to search for Appearance. And there's one called Change System Appearance. We're going to drag that in here. And what this allows us to do is either toggle the light and dark modes, switch to dark, or switch to light. So we'll leave it on toggle light dark. Now this is all we wanted to do. So I'm just going to go to File, Save, and I'm going to give it a name. And this is the name that will appear then in the menu. So I want to make sure it's something good. I'm going to do light-dark and save it. So now when I go to any application menu like this, go to Services, I'll see Light Dark there. And I can select it to switch modes. Now the first time you run this you may get asked permission, like Automator wants permission to access System Appearance. And you would have to say OK. Now unfortunately you're going to be asked this permission the first time you run this automated workflow in each app. So if you get asked in Automator you won't get asked in Automator again. If you then run another app, let's say Reminders, and I go to Services here and I switch, then it's going to ask me in Reminders, but once I say OK it will never ask me in Reminders again. So it's a little annoying, but it's the price we pay to be a little more secure. Now that we have this in a menu item here, we can assign a keyboard shortcut to it. So let's go into System Preferences and here I'm going to go to Keyboard and then Shortcuts, and then I'm going to go to App Shortcuts and hit the plus button. And I'm going to say in all applications, let's do the menu title and we have to type exactly whatever we called this workflow. It needs to match this perfectly. So light-dark, and let's do the keyboard shortcut. So I'm going to do Command-Shift-F1 and add it. And now you can see light-dark, Command-Shift-F1. And we'll exit from there. And now when we go to Services we'll see Command-Shift-F1 for light dark. And I can use that keyboard shortcut to quickly switch between light and dark modes. So as a bonus, if you wanted this in the dock instead, what you could do is create an Automator workflow that is an application instead. And then add the same thing there. Toggle light dark. We'll save it. We'll save it in our applications folder. We'll call it light dark. You can save this in your documents folder. And then if we go and look for that in the Finder, we'll go to the applications folder here. I'll find light dark and I can drag that to the dock and I can see it appear there. So now I can click that and it's going to ask permission that first time, but then after that I can switch as much as I want by hitting that in the dock. So two different ways to do it.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.